Hi, I'm now in the city of Sapa in North Vietnam, and I've come here for a very special reason. We've come to see a hydropower station in the mountains of Sapa.
However, this is no ordinary hydropower station. It's a little different. It's a unique collaboration between China and Vietnam, and is powering the future of this region. But first, we need to rewind. Around 15 years ago, a groundbreaking partnership was formed between China Southern Power Grid and the Vietnamese Northern Power Corporation. Their mission, to harness the power of Sapa's natural resources while ensuring sustainable development. This collaboration resulted in the creation of a hydropower station that not only supplies electricity to Vietnam's national grid, but also brings power to the local communities. We've now arrived at the hydropower station, so let me tell you a little more about this joint venture project.
So, the water actually comes from a reservoir right up the top here, and it comes down this pipe, and then it enters the turbine hall, turns the turbines, which generate power at around 10 kilovolts. There's three turbines, and they run the three turbines most of the year, but not all the year. Obviously, they have to shut some down for maintenance.
When the water flows through the turbines and leaves the turbine house, it flows down here and then into this reservoir here. It then continues its journey down the mountain.
And once the turbines have generated that power, it goes into this transformer station here, where they have three transformers, one for each turbine, and this transforms it into 110 kilovolts, and that is then sent across these transmission lines and pylons up here and distributed to the local area. A lot of the power is used in the local area, and before this hydropower station was here, actually, the locals had almost no power, and now they all have power. But it generates about 30 megawatts, and that's more than enough for the local area. So they actually push some into the Vietnam grid as well, which is then distributed to cities further away. We're now at 1,500 meters above sea level. This is around 800 meters above the power station. The turbine hall, and this yellow building here, this is the inlet. So the water comes from this reservoir and it drops under the force of gravity down a huge pipe, basically a channel. And then when it gets into the turbine hall, the pressure of that water turns those turbines, which then generates the electricity. And it seems the reservoir is pretty full. They've built this dam here to store this water. Actually, the reservoir is a little bit bigger. If we can get some other shots around the other side, we can see. So you can see the dam here, and this is a gate they can open. If the dam gets too full, they can relieve the amount of water in the dam, and that flows through the sort of gate down there and flows off down the mountain. But yeah, I mean, it's all this has had to be constructed, and the reason why Vietnam partnered with China to do this product is actually they set up a joint company between the Vietnamese company and China South Power Grid Corporation, because China have the expertise and the experience and the technical ability to undertake big sort of infrastructure projects like this. It all kind of blends in with the environment. They haven't damaged the environment to build this. And it's a really, really great project. It's very good how they've built this, using natural resources to give electricity to many, many people. So right now the reservoir's not at its fullest. It's not really low, but it's not full. Actually, the rainy season here is between July and October. So in the rainy season time, sometimes they have to open the sluice gates to relieve the reservoir because it gets quite full. But in 2022, they installed an additional 8 megawatt turbines. So now they have 3 turbines. So the engineer was saying that they don't have to open the sluice gates so often. Each turbine uses about 4.8 cubic meters per second. So there's quite a large flow down the mountain from this reservoir. And what makes this project even more interesting is that before this dam and power station was built, there actually wasn't a road. And it would take the locals like maybe 1 to 2 hours to walk into the village and to aid getting all the construction material up here. One of the first things they had to do was build a road. And that's really benefited the locals because now they can get to the village in 5 to 10 minutes on their motorbike. So that's been a massive benefit to the villagers.
So this project in Sapa is more than just a success story. It's a model for future collaborations between nations. It shows that with mutual respect, shared goals, and a commitment to sustainability, great things can be achieved. And as we move forward, let this be a reminder of the power of collaboration. Sapa's Xiaochongho Hydropower Station is lighting the way for a brighter and more sustainable future.
So not only has the building of this project given electricity to many, many thousands of people in this province who didn't have electricity before, but the joint company also undergoes kind of social responsibility projects. They've, like I mentioned earlier, they've built the road, which is really great for locals to get to and from the village. They help with healthcare. They have projects for the local schools for kids to better their education. And it's just a really great example of how China and Chinese companies cooperate with other AESN countries to actually improve the lives of people and help countries that don't have as much technical expertise in infrastructure as China do. So it's really, really great to see this kind of cooperation, and I hope we can see more of this type of cooperation in the future. However, as always, from Sapa, Vietnam, for now, take care.